accept, please wear a face covering on our trains and at our stations. Please remember to socially distance where possible.
My first narrated video, so bear with me, it's going to be a little bit awkward, but hopefully I should be able to show you a bit of London and tell you my thoughts about how I felt getting out of lockdown. Also, I have to apologise because I'm not used to this camera and I ended up putting my hand over the microphone every now and then, so you get these really annoying kind of muffled sounds, but hopefully it should improve as I record more videos in the future. So as you could see on the train a minute ago, and out here in Waterloo, people were really not out and about that day. Now, maybe it was because it was a work day, it was a Monday, but, you know, first day out of lockdown, I thought, you know, maybe it'd be a bit busier than this, but nope. Personally, I couldn't wait to get the hell out of lockdown because I'd just been going on these walks in my local area, just going to the same bloody places over and over and over again. And now, like, finally I get a chance to go into central London and actually do something. So that's kind of what I did in this video. I just had a little kind of date by myself. Liked this poem for a number of reasons. One, because I hate winter. It's literally the worst season. It's just miserable and dark, especially in the UK. It's just freezing cold. And then we've also been in this freaking lockdown for ages, which has been shit. And also, I've been unemployed. So that's like, you know, a triple whammy. So this poem was quite nice to see. It was very uplifting, quite nice. love this view. It's Charing Cross Bridge, I think, and it's basically like a Waterloo, and it goes across Charing Cross Station, and it's kind of like railway bridge, but it's got two pedestrian bridges on either side, and you get this amazing view of the city, St. Paul's Cathedral, and then if you go sort of towards the Charing Cross end and look over the water, you can see Canary Wharf, and you can see just so many different things like the Shard. And it's actually really beautiful at night. I recommend it as a kind of date spot. Definitely bring your date here. Be very romantic. Trafalgar Square in lockdown, I tell you that. I would come here with my friends, would sit at the bottom of Nelson's Column, having a beer, having something to drink, and just kind of chilling. And it'd be great. You'd have it all to yourself late at night. You get this beautiful view down Whitehall. That's something I really, really have missed in lockdown. So hopefully I'll be able to do that again soon. I seriously could not have asked for better weather than this day. Like, first day of the lockdown, and the sun was just shining. It had that little crispness to the air, you know, that little crispy nature to it, where it wasn't like roasting hot, but it was just warm enough to feel like you were actually coming out of something. Oh, and here's another thing that I really miss. Jeez, the pub. Oh my God, I want to go back to a pub so badly. Oh my God. So as you can see, they've still got the lanterns up from the Chinese New Year. And a fun fact about that sign there, that's actually the Cantonese way of basically saying like good wishes and fortune for the year to come. It doesn't actually mean Happy New Year. So yeah, just a little tidbit for you. And I bought some lovely matcha milk tea here. And oh my god, I missed it so much. But it is so expensive. It's like £4.65 for one cup of milk tea here. So just be prepared for that. But, you know, it's worth it when you're thousands and thousands of miles away from an actual East Asian country. So I wanted to talk a bit about my current situation. As some of you watching may know, right now I'm having a bit of quite a big dilemma. So basically my girlfriend, who I met here in the UK back in August 2020, is from Singapore. and she's actually going back there in August. And, you know, that's totally fine because I want to live in Singapore too. But here's the problem. I spent the last 4 months probably desperately applying for jobs in Singapore, probably 1,000 at this point, and none of my applications have been successful. In fact, I only had one interview for this really awesome sales job, but because of Singaporean law regarding foreigners, they would have had to pay me way more than they would pay a local. So despite wanting me, they didn't have the budget for it. So basically decided that if I still don't have a job secured in Singapore in kind of the next month and a half or so, I'm going to go to Taiwan, probably teach English, as I'm definitely nowhere near fluent in Mandarin to get most of those normal jobs. So sadly, obviously, this would mean breaking up with my girlfriend because I really just simply refuse to do long distance. I know I would absolutely hate that. And yeah, the situation sucks, but you know, these kind of things, you know, they happen, and sometimes there's just nothing you can do about it. Anyway, stay tuned for more videos, and I'll let you know whether I'm headed to Taiwan or Singapore. Whatever happens though, it will be an adventure, I'm sure. But for now, I hope you're enjoying the beautiful London scenery from the first day out of lockdown.
find that tuna thing.